Hello everyone, this is Kevin, your entrepreneur, and let's talk about Uber Eats today. Now, I've been using Uber Eats most of the week as a customer, and this isn't just because I wanted to do research on it for this particular video. It's because Uber recently launched Uber Eats in my area, like full-blown. I mean, it was near me. If I drove like 3 or 4 miles, like I could deliver for Uber Eats or order Uber Eats, but at my specific house, I couldn't order it yet, and that has changed. Now I can order Uber Eats, and as a way to celebrate the launch, Uber pretty much said that, hey, if you, as long as you redeem this before Friday, we will give you up to 3 meals for free, so long as they're less than $20. And so I redeemed those 3 free meals because I'm not going to necessarily say no to food, especially free food. And yes, I gave all the drivers cash tips. I'm not a monster. And then I decided to check out the app one more time to see how much it would cost me to have it delivered. And the results, frankly, shocked me. And to show why it shocked me, I'm going to show you what the other places charge for delivery, at least the ones that are available to me. So let's look at Grubhub first. As you can see, the $10 order, they want to charge a $5 delivery fee, well, $4.99, and they have the tip option right up front. It's hard to miss, so that you can give a tip. Now, I don't like that they have the 0% right there, but whatever. Next, we go to Postmates, which Postmates is the one that fluctuates the most. They were charging me a $3.75 fee, which they probably would have charged more for, because one of the things with Postmates is since they do pay on a per mile basis as well, they will normally put a higher hold on the card just in case it's a little bit longer, but they're charging $3.75. You go to DoorDash, they're charging $5.99. Now, it says delivery free for me because I have a promo code that I have never quite redeemed yet, but yeah, normally it would be $6. How much is Uber Eats charging? 99 cents. Like, what the heck? How on earth is Uber making money from that? And I called Chili's, because this is what the order is from, Chili's, and asked the manager about this delivery fee. And I point-blankly asked him, does Uber get this 99 cent fee, or does Chili's get the 99 cent fee? The manager told me that Chili's gets the 99 cent delivery fee, but he believes it is then redirected to Uber. Which, of course, since this is Uber's app, I don't know why they don't just take the fee to begin with, whatever. So let's take a look at it this way. With the other three services, you get paid $4 or $5 per delivery. And depending what service you're using, you will also get paid additional dollars per miles if it goes above a certain distance that you need to take it. From what I understand, Uber works very much the same way. You get $4, and if it goes above a certain distance, you get a 80 cent per mile charge. And of course, there is no tip option on the Uber Eats. So up front, again, it is still a much better deal for drivers to deliver for these other services than Uber Eats. But this does raise the question, how does Uber Eats make its money? And here is the answer. Point blank, they don't make money off Uber Eats. Here's the thing. Uber got into the ride-sharing business early and aggressively, and they more or less captured the market, and Lyft has been attempting to gain some of that market share ever since, and they have remained a distant second ever since. So Uber got in early enough in that market to dominate it, and they did not see food delivery on demand being nearly as big as it was. And I don't know who got there first, DoorDash or Postmates, but the bottom line is there are multiple delivery app services that have gotten a lot of market share, and now, in a strange twist, Uber has to catch up with that. So, what they are basically doing is they are doing their Uber Eats service for free. They are taking a wash. This is what people in the business call, sarcastically, of course, throwing money at the competition. Basically, even though Uber Eats restaurant options are severely, severely limited, like you are so limited to what you can order through Uber Eats, the bottom line is it is a lot more attractive to a customer to spend 99 cents for delivery and not have to tip, and in fact being made impossible to tip unless you have cash on you, than these other services which are charging you $4 to $6 up front plus a tip. And in that process, Uber is effectively taking a hit. They are eating the cost of delivering the food. And this isn't an unusual tactic. Places like Amazon do it all the time when they want to drive someone else out of business with their own product. And the whole idea is, once you've grown the market, once you've defeated the competition, then the profits can be made. It is the Jeff Bezos mentality business. You grow the market first, then the profits come. Of course, the issue comes is that when it's time for the profits to be made, they're going to have to charge more than 99 cents for delivery, and that will, of course, be a big deterrent from what drove people to the service in the first place. But if they're also the only game in town, they can do that. So basically, Uber Eats is not profitable. It is not going to be profitable for a while, and unless some of the other companies start going out of business, it's never going to be profitable. So here's the thing. As a driver, I can definitely tell you, deliver for the other companies. Even Postmates, who are kind of siphoning your tips at the moment, they're so much better. They're so much more practical reasons to drive for them. If you're a customer and you don't mind having limited options, though, Uber Eats is going to be very attractive. And if Uber Eats can grow their restaurant selection, they could, unfortunately, be a force to be reckoned with. So we're going to have to keep an eye on this. Anyway, that's my opinion. That's my advice for you guys. What do you think? Have you tried ordering from any of these services yourself? I'd like to know. Comment below. Like, favorite, share, subscribe. And as always, flame responsibly. Have a good one.